Hello, my friends. I have made a little presentation for you about the Monty Hall problem. Come in and see it. Welcome to the Monty Hall Game Show. That's the name of the show he did, I'm pretty sure. This is the three doors from the show that we all know and love. Behind one of the doors is a brand new automobile that you can drive around in on roads and things like that. Behind two of the other doors is a goat, is a goat, the animal, the goat. I think that's cool, but most people probably would not. So you're probably gonna want to go for the car. Here's the strategy you're gonna want to go with. Take it from me. I studied the hell out of the Wikipedia page 2 hours ago. So here's the thing. You're gonna want to pick a goat at first. And you don't exactly have any choice in the matter. It's not like you can manifest that the goat is gonna be behind the door. But just so you know, you're gonna want to pick a goat for the first round. A goat in this scenario is not just a goat. A goat is your chance to win. A goat is your chance to switch to the car for sure. So the way you're gonna wanna look at it, if you're an insane person like me, is behind two out of three of the doors is for sure a car. Like for sure. A car, you win. And behind one of the doors, and this is again, this is just for the first round. And behind one of the doors is maybe it's a car. Is like a 1 in 3 chance that it's a car, which is low. So you've chosen the green door. And now Mr. Game Show comes up to you and he says, "Guess what, my friend? Guess what? Just you wait and see, my friend, because I will now show you what is behind this door that you did not pick." Now, in doing so, he is basically eliminating this door as an option. And he's also revealing that it has, ba-ba-ba-ba, a goat. Mr. Game Show was always gonna pick a door with a goat because if he opened a random other door and was like, "Oh, this one's the car, sorry." No, they want to extend the game out so that you have to pick for the next round to amp up the tension, you know? He was always gonna pick a door with a goat behind it. So what he's done by revealing that this door that you didn't pick had a goat behind it, he's turned this door into a guaranteed car for you if you have the goat door. Keep in mind, there is a 2 in 3 chance that this door is a goat door, and therefore you switch, you win. 2 in 3 chance you win right now. That's why you always switch. Does that make sense? I feel like that made sense. So then you open this door, and guess what? They're both this fucking nothing in either door, I guess. I forgot to add the goats for this one. So yeah, there you go. Now you know. Ba-ba-ba-ba, it's the car. It's the fucking car, obviously. It's him with the car. He's handing you the keys to the car because it is now your car. That's just the actor they hired to hand you the keys to the car. He's not important. He's not Mr. Game Show or whatever his name is. So that's the thing. That's how you figure out the game show problem. Consider it solved. I solved it all by myself just now. You're welcome.